map say?
The map says that we are out of phone range. We're gonna be fine, but look where we are. We're on an adventure right now.
Just out of curiosity, what time is this? Sunset?
I'm planning on not brushing my teeth for the entire trip.
You will be. You will definitely be brushing your teeth.
No, I don't think I'm going
to. Oh, yeah. That's happening.
Yeah.
I have to knock you out and do it myself.
You're going
to
brush my teeth while I'm unconscious?
Yes.
That's very nice of you. I never knew you loved me so much.
Oh, yeah.
What are you doing? Stop it. Stop it. Ooh. I'm going to turn around and pee on
you. No. Babe?
Yeah?
Hi. We are lost.
But I don't feel lost. Do you feel lost? Are you tired? You're tired, aren't you? I know you do. Hey, open your eyes. Open your eyes.
Yeah, they're open. I need to stop for a second. You're right, we should just stay out here. We'll get a little bit of sleep, and then,
I can't wait to start shooting this thing tomorrow.
I bet the stars are pretty tonight.
Holy moly. Okay, I'm signing up. We're in. I'm never going back home. That's it.
Wow. This is the place, right?
Oh my god,
it's
my back.
So charming, isn't it?
Whoa! Oh my, it's perfect. Hey, I was thinking you and I could start a nudist colony here. What do you think?
Sign me up.
Yeah, sign me up. Oh my god, there's a rocking chair.
This is incredible.
It's insane.
Wow. I think you're scaring the birds.
Uh-oh. Do you ever wish your life had an eject button? Good morning. I'm happy to report the sun rose again in the east today. Do you ever fantasize about selling everything and moving to the woods? I think I found Nirvana last night, 7:43, and I was standing right there. Do you wish you could walk around your yard naked? Do you ever wish you could freeze time? Do you ever wish you could kiss your wife the way you did on the night you first met? Well, the sun rose again today. A bird flew by. A squirrel ate a nut.
So, this thing, this is recording you while it's recording me.
Yeah. Pretty sweet, right?
I have one fabulous...
Have you ever started to suspect you made a huge mistake?
You're so smart.
Have you ever realized you ran over your head? Have you ever realized you can't really go back? Well, it's interesting out here. Being in the woods is... Have you ever moved to the woods for a whole year to work on your relationship? Only a month in, you missed your TV more than you thought. Plus, you stopped taking your meds, and you have no idea what this movie is about in the first place. Let's face it, trading in your studio apartment for a bunch of trees doesn't really change anything.
What are you doing right now?
What if Penny put a photography career on hold for you, so you were too ashamed to admit that the documentary you moved here to make wasn't that well thought out anyway? What? But what if your real problems were much, much worse than that?
You haven't shot anything for weeks.
Penny. of your relationship troubles are the least of your worries.
Doesn't want to get out of his hammock? Doesn't want to film anything?
All right.
I don't know why.
All right.
I don't know why.
What if something else was out there?
I love you. I'm just not in the mood.
Why aren't you in the mood?
Can you open the door now, please? Oh, my God.
Something that hadn't been disturbed for a long, long time. What if you came to the woods to find solitude? Only you found out you weren't really alone.
I'm sorry about earlier. I shouldn't have yelled at you like that.
It's fine.
I think you were right. I needed to shoot some stuff and really need a swift kick in the ass. That's awesome. Thank you for that, seriously. Oh, that's nice. Isn't that nice? I think we just needed some relaxation time, you know? Let me give you a massage. Come on, let me give you a massage. Relaxation time, free massage on the house.
What are you doing?
Giving you pleasure.
No, what's going on with you?
Nothing. I'm good, all good. You good?
Honestly, I've been worried about you.
Well, you don't need to be, just relax.
No, you've been acting really alarmingly.
Yeah.
In the last couple of...
I stopped taking my pills temporarily when we first got out here, but I'm fine.
You stopped taking your pills?
No.
I gave up everything to come out here with you. I left my job, my friends. And you promised me, you would be responsible.
Penny, let's just go to sleep and talk about this tomorrow.
No, I want to talk about it now. Scott. Scott.
Come. Are you all right? What the hell's going on out there? Okay, just stay there. I'm gonna go take a look. It's just birds. It's just birds. They're gonna be free.
52. And Penny and I are... It was good. Yeah, last night was good. Sometimes you just gotta let the blood out, you know? Passion pumping, you know? When you come out to a place like this, it's like there's this huge wall. That's where it's at. That's where the good stuff is.
Hey! You want my car keys? Hey! I have to show you something.
God, Jesus.
I'm sorry. Excuse me. Anybody here?
For a second, that's all.
Go where? There?
Yes.
Why would you want to go down there? Why didn't you take your backpack? What's down there?
I left the keys in there.
You what?
Yeah.
That's a 10-mile hike.
I know. I already know, okay? I'm an idiot.
Don't go in there, okay?
This is the most interesting thing I've seen in a month. Just let me know if he comes, okay?
Scott! Jesus.
Dropping by.
Are you gonna stay here?
And your perspective at the same time in the film. What do you think? I mean, only if you're cool with it, because this is your thing.
Yeah, right? No, it's good.
Yeah,
I like it.
Yeah. Cool. Well,
I left you a message about possibly interviewing you later today. I'm just the first time.
Yeah? Okay.
All right. And then we'll have you sit right here.
All right.
And...
knowing why you're interested, but... yeah, you don't have to tell me if you don't want to.
Why do you run your website if you're so afraid of it?
To help people.
You ready? Testing. Blah, blah, blah.
Master's degree in both consciousness studies and alternative medicine. And I'm working on my dissertation at the University of somewhere.
So where do you want me to start?
Tell us about how you discovered Mr. Jones.
Okay. So one day, early 70s, I ran a gallery in the village. And I get this huge crate in the mail. You could have fit a refrigerator in there. I open it up, and there is sitting there inside this thing.
I started to get reports about these people getting these packages all over the country. A dentist in Oregon, a bartender in Iowa. I had no idea why these people were being singled out, but it intrigued me.
And I go home, and I have about 5 drinks, and I go to bed. I can't get the thing out of my head. I just couldn't get it out of my head. Finally, I wake up from this dream where I'm actually having a dream inside the dream about finding it.
Nobody knew who he was. Nobody still knows that. There were all these crazy rumors. He was a concentration camp guard who was hiding out in Georgia. He was on death row. He was a housewife in Ohio. He was a mental patient. He was a dentist in Washington State. He was
Mr. Jones. That was me. I named him.
I was pretty angry at the world at this time. I was about to go broke. So I just hung this thing in the front window of the gallery, and it stopped drinking.
When I
first saw Mr. Jones's famous scarecrows, I immediately thought of totem poles, tribal masks, guardian figures that occur in every culture to stop the evil spirits that dwell in the dark from breaking into our own.
So what happened next?
Well, eventually they just stopped. And that was it. And I thought Mr. Jones was done.
So you think you got an actual piece sent you by Mr. Jones?
I don't think I did. I did.
Most experts think he sent these things out in the 70s. I didn't know it was real.
It was real. I know it was.
There are 9 verified Jones pieces in the world. 9. If someone found an authentic Jones, I could get 7 figures for it tomorrow. Easy. But if it was a new piece, any new piece, contemporary, like what he's doing now.
If these are worth so much, then why did you destroy it?
I've met a lot of people that were mailed totems by Mr. Jones. And most of them just say that they were disturbed and moved on. But if you actually start talking to the people around them, their husbands, their wives, their friends, their colleagues, their parents, then you start to get a different story.
Why do you think he singled you out?
I have no idea.
And you dig deeper into the lives of these people and you notice even more drastic changes, extreme personality shifts, disappearances, housewives leaving their families and moving into the woods. It's disturbing.
Who do you think you're dealing with?
I'm sorry?
Do you think this is like a painter or something? You have no idea what you're dealing with. This guy, you don't know what he's capable of. And he's still out there. He's sending these things out to innocent people. And we don't know why, or we don't know, nobody cares, nobody's doing anything about it. You got no idea what these things do to your mind.
What do you mean?
They get inside your mind and they explode.
Hey, babe. I'm here, and you are, who knows, somewhere in New York. And I miss you. No sign of Mr. Jones, but I've been taking a lot of pictures, and I don't know, these things seem so familiar. Hypnotic. think your work is amazing. And, I was actually just taking pictures because I want to create a book. You know what? Would you be okay if we did an interview, maybe? I'm so inspired. You know what? I'm sorry. Maybe I'll, just... Scott, you need to see them in the dark. It's like the air around them is vibrating. I just feel like I need to record this before I forget, because I feel like I just woke up from a dream, you know? You know how in a dream you can tell if someone is trying to hurt you or help you? Like, you know, you don't just see into them, you see, like, right through them, you know? It's like I could feel his intentions. You know? And I don't feel scared.
so-called primitive people didn't see the world the way we do. They thought the dream world was real, not some meaningless neurological side effect of sleep. There was the waking world of order, cause and effect, time and space, and another, a very real world that you glimpsed in dreams.
It is hard to believe that one person, after so many years, could be responsible for building all of these totems and sending them all over the world. So there's some that posit that perhaps there is a secret group or sect at work here, building these things and sending them out for ceremonial purposes.
These talismans were created by the holy men to patrol the borders of these two worlds as they overlapped, kind of a where the photo dissolves into another, to keep the chaos and insanity and nightmares of the dream world from entering our own.
Maybe they're working together. Maybe they're all on their own. Maybe they're all inspired by the same dreams. It's almost as if the Mr. Jones mythos has a life of its own, constantly striving to survive by feeding on our imaginations and in the process, occasionally transforming people into additional Mr. Joneses.
So what happened after you got the statue from Mr. Jones?
It's not really a statue, is it?
Okay, then what should I call it?
There's not really a word for it.
So, what happened to you?
I started having a nightmare.
So, what would we see if we saw this other world?
It depends on what we bring to it. An inverse reflection of our own. Madness, bedlam, paradoxes that'll split your mind.
Can you tell us about this nightmare?
I'm chasing myself. I'm trying to hurt myself. And, if I catch myself, it's going to spill out and infect the whole world.
So this is a dream you have, like, every night?
You don't understand. I started having the dream. I haven't stopped.
So what would happen if these guys failed at their job?
You could forever be lost in the purgatory of these two worlds, or have the courage to see yourself as a whole in both the worlds, the awake world and the dream world.
Tell us a little bit about the troubles you've been having in your life.
No, I don't think I want to talk about that. Like, I know you guys think you're telling, like, a fun little story, but you need to stop. Don't talk to anyone else who's had contact with him. Don't try to track down his works. Don't look for him. And if you think you have found Mr. Jones, don't speak to him, don't listen to him, don't go near him. And if he comes near you, run.
Look, we do have to be careful, but Penny, that guy I interviewed obviously had problems. I mean, everyone else I talked to, if they found out we found Mr. Jones, it would be huge. If we're really going to make this documentary, we got to explore that basement. And you got to take pictures of his workshop. I feel like we only saw a tenth of that place the first time. It would be the perfect ending for this movie.
Yeah.
Penny.
Yeah.
You know, we'll use walkie-talkies. I don't know, like, keep an eye out for him, so he doesn't like... What? What's up?
You're gone.
Wow. Yeah, okay.
I can't really explain it.
What happened here? Just, tell me what you were telling me before about how it was a dream. That was really good. So trippy.
I mean, if he's using these as scarecrows, and I felt like he was leading me home, you know? And whatever he's, it was like he was trying to get me away from whatever he's trying to scare away, you know? I mean, whatever he sees up.
Hey. You okay?
You're so familiar.
So, I'm just gonna go in there for like 2 seconds. I'm gonna come right back. Okay? Everything's gonna be okay. Okay. I'm at the hatch. Jeez. Okay. There is a ladder. And it goes down.
All right. I'm going down. Okay, just be quick, all right?
I forgot the camera. Okay.
Scott.
really need you. I really need you to hear me right now. I don't know what...
Listen to me! We are not safe in this house!
I don't know what's wrong with it. The battery's fine, everything's fine. It just doesn't work. In the morning, we'll get out of here, okay? When does the sun rise? 6:30. Sense. He's doing something to us. I wish I hadn't gone down there. And it was... I'm sorry.
About what?
Everything.
You don't have anything to be sorry about.
As it gets light, we run. It's gonna get light out soon. It'll be a nice walk in the woods. We're gonna be fine.
What time is it?
6:15. Got about 10 minutes before we gotta go. Gonna be fine. This night has lasted hours, days. My mind's getting cloudy. There's something in the woods. It does something to your head. I can feel things. inside. I can feel things watching me from inside my own.
Where's the other flashlight?
It's in my bag.
Scott, what is this?
Just something I took from the basement.
Why did you take it?
I lost my job, my friends. You promised
you know what?
You would be responsible.
To see the world from another's eyes. To be in a nightmare and never to be able to wake up without a fuck stuff.
Up in this blue room. And watch myself sleep.
The dream world, the nightmare world!
Can't you feel it? Everything is loose.
Stop it. You're not making any sense.
Can't you feel it? Didn't you see what happened to him? What we did to the scarecrow when you went in the basement and took him, he's stuck.
Wild guess.
Jones is gone, Scott. So who's going to protect us now?
It was important. Scott, okay? Wake up, Mr. Jones. Scott, we have to get out of this house. We've got to go through it. Okay? We have to go through it. We have to go in the woods.
I don't want
to
go in the woods!
She's not Scotty. No, no, no. Look at me. Stay with me, okay? Don't go near her.
She's not the real Penny. I never came back to the house.
Scott.
Do not put on the mask. Do not go back down there.
Thank you. is gone. Scott.
They must be
waking world. A hoarder.
Caught in the fog.
Not in sleep.
You have to put on a mask.
Another for very real world that you glimpsed in dreams.
Wake up, Mr. Jones.
These talismans were created by the holy men to patrol the borders of these two worlds as they overlapped.
You have to stay behind Scott.
To keep the chaos and insanity and the nightmares of the dream world from under another. He was a shaman, warding off evil spirits, protecting this world from destruction.
That's not part of the plan.